हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम रिंकू दीमन, वर्किंग एज एन असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट एट आरपी आईआईटी टेक्निकल एंड मेडिकल कैंपस करना। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस ओपन लूप कंट्रोल सिस्टम वर्सेस क्लोज लूप कंट्रोल सिस्टम। सो ओपन लूप कंट्रोल सिस्टम, एन ओपन लूप कंट्रोल सिस्टम टेक्स इनपुट अंडर द कंसिडरेशन एंड डज नॉट रिएक्ट ऑन द फीडबैक to obtain the output. This is why it is also called a non-feedback control system. So simply we can say in our open loop system, the output does not depend upon your input control basically. So it does not react on the feedback to obtain the output. So that's why it is also called a non-feedback control system. So there are no disturbances or variation in this system, and it works on a fixed condition. So we can see over here, we are here a desired output response. We will set this thing, and there is an actuating device. So we will feed this desired output response to our actuating device. The actuating device will take decision on this, and that decision or that control signal fed to our process, and we will get a desired output as per our input which we are feeding like an our desired output response. So this is our open loop control system. Simply we can understand by this figure also, we are giving input as a set point, and that set point is fed to the controller. Say we are setting, we are putting a value like 30 degrees Celsius temperature to our system. So that is fed to our controller. Controller make action on this, and that signal fed to the final control element, say actuator, and that signal fed to our process. And the process will take make an action according to our input control signal, and we will get a controlled variable or controlled output we can say. Closed loop control system. In a closed loop system, it is also referred as a feedback control system. This system record the output instead of input and modify it according to the need. It generates preferred condition of the output as compared to the original one. It does not encounter any external or internal disturbances. So simply we can understand this thing like we are putting as input like a desired output response. We will compare this input with our output that is measured by some sensor over here. So this is the measuring element, say we can feedback sensor we can use over here. Then this output will compare with our desired response, and it will generate some error. That error will fed over here to this controller. This controller will take action on the basis of that error. Either it will increase the gain or reduce the gain, and that control signal is fed to our process, and that process will justify this control action and will make our output desired. So this is also called feedback control system because we are using output to measure as a feedback element and fed to the input as a for a comparison purpose. So this is also called a feedback control system. Simply we can understand this thing by this example also. We are giving input as a desired output response. Say we want to our output should be like 40 degrees Celsius, right? And if the system output is like 30 degrees Celsius, and we measure this output with this sensing element, so it can be any temperature measuring sensor like thermocouple, RTD, etc. So it will measure this temperature, it will fed this error detector. Say 40 was there, 30 it measured, then there will be an error of 10 degrees Celsius. This 10 degrees Celsius we have to fed our system. That system include our basically plant and control element. So we can say this 10 degrees Celsius fed to our controller, it will reduce the temperature to 10 degrees Celsius, and that 10 degrees Celsius reduced temperature output as a control signal fed to our plant, and that plant will give the output like 30 degrees Celsius, or we can say that it will increase the temperature 10 degrees Celsius, so we'll get the 40 degrees Celsius temperature desire we have to put. So this is all about the feedback control system. Open loop control system. In open loop control system, we can understand simply by a driver example, like we are just giving a signal to our control unit, and that control unit put input signal to our driver, and that driver will drive our motor. So simply we are not using any feedback element over. So this is our open loop control system. In closed loop control system, our motor output will measure by this feedback element, and that is fed to control unit. It will make a comparison, it will make an action, either the speed will be increased or decrease, that is done by this control unit, and that is increasing or decreasing speed based on this control action we will fed to our driver, and the driver will give an output to the motor for to moving purpose, like it will increase the speed or decrease this. So this is feedback control system. Now again we will make a comparison of closed loop and open loop system. So here is a list given for a comparison of open loop and control system. So the first, say in open loop control system, the feed element is absent. As we already seen, there is no output feedback element. And simply in closed loop system, there is feedback element is always present. An error detector is not present in open loop. Otherwise, an error detector was present in the closed loop system. So it is stable one, and it may become unstable sometime. Easy to construct, open loop system is easy to construct, but either we can say closed loop system is complicated to construction, because we have to need to measure our output by feedback element and then make an error detector over there. So number of component is added over there, so it will become more complicated to construct. It is economical because number of components are very less to use, and it is costly. And having small bandwidth, we can say, because it is limited time span we are using for control action. Otherwise, in closed loop control system, large bandwidth criteria is there. And open loop system is inaccurate, and closed loop system is accurate, because we are measuring our control action by comparing our input and the desired output response. Less maintenance is there is open loop, and more maintenance in closed loop control system. Open loop system are unreliable, and closed loop system is reliable. And finally, if we take the example hand dryer, tea maker, these are the example of our open loop system. And servo voltage stabilizer or perspirations are these are the example of our closed loop control system. So application we'll discuss in further slide in detail. So these are the practical example of our open loop control system. Simply we can say electric hand dryer. This is the best example of our open loop control system. So suppose hot air comes out, as long as you keep your hand under the machine, irrespective of how much your hand is dried. The second one is automatic washing machine. The machine is run according to preset time, irrespective of washing is completed or not. ओके जब तक हम उसका टाइम सेट करते हैं उसने तभी तक मूव करना है, अदरवाइज हमें उसको मतलब नहीं होता कि हमारे कपड़े धुले हैं या नहीं धुले, राइट. देन ब्रेड टोस्टर इज द अनदर एग्जांपल. द मशीन इज रन एज पर प्री एडजस्टेड टाइम, बेसिकली इरिस्पेक्टिव ऑफ टोस्टिंग इज कंप्लीटेड और नॉट. ऑटोमेटिक टी और कॉफी मेकर, दिस मशीन ऑल्सो फंक्शन फॉर प्री एडजस्ट टाइम ओनली, आइदर योर टी इज रेडी और नॉट. Time-based clothes dryers. This machine dries wet cloth for pre-adjusted time. It does not matter how much the cloth are dried. The similarly, light switch. Lamps glow whenever light switch is on, irrespective of light is required or not. And finally, volume stereo system. Volume adjusted manually irrespective of output volume level. So these are the practical example of our open loop control system. Similarly, closed loop control system have some practical example like automatic electric iron. In this, heating element is controlled by output temperature of the iron. And servo voltage stabilizer is the best example for that. Voltage controller operate depending upon the output voltage of the system. And water level controller, input water is controlled by water level of the reservoir. Missile launched and auto-tracked by radar. This direction of missile is controlled by comparing the target and position of the missile. And air conditioner. Air conditioner is the best example for closed loop system. Air conditioner function depending upon the temperature of the room. So it will again make the closed loop element kind of things. Then again, cooling system in car, it operate depending upon the temperature which it controls. So these are the best example of our closed loop control system. Now there are some advantages and disadvantages of open loop control system and closed loop control system. So first of all, we discuss the open loop control system advantages. So simple in construction and design, and it is very economical, already discussed. Number of components are very less. Say error detector and feedback element are missing over there in comparison to closed loop control. So it is less costly. So easy to maintain over there. Generally, if these are stable system, because there is no comparison of the elements and all. And finally, convenient to use as output is difficult to measure. So jin systems ka output measure karna difficult hai by using of feedback control system. So conveniently we can measure this by the open loop control system. But there are some disadvantages. They are inaccurate, they are unreliable, and any change in output cannot be corrected automatically. So these are the disadvantages of our open loop control system. Otherwise, closed loop control system have many more advantages in comparison to open loop system. The first one is closed loop control system are more accurate even presence of known linearity. So if there will be some kind of saturation, there will be some kind of disturbances or environmental impact, closed loop system give the more accurate reading. Then high accurate, as any error arising is corrected due to presence of feedback signal. So we are measuring the output as a feedback signal and compare with our set point. So if there is any error or environmental error, so that can be corrected by this feedback signal by comparing with the set point. Bandwidth range is very large. Facilitate automation. So already discussed in practical examples in automatic machine, air conditioners. So these are the best example of facilitate automations. And finally, the sensitivity of system may be made small to make system more stable. So as the feedback element is very sensitive to output, and they give the relative stability of the system, very close stable system we can say, and the system is less affected by noise. Already told you like that these system are not affected by environmental disturbances or noise kind of things. There are some disadvantages of closed loop system. So the first one is they are costly. It means like we are using the feedback element, some additional comparison component over there. So it is costly in comparison to open loop system. So they are complicated design. The controller for the closed loop system designing is very complicated. Required more maintenance, more component add over there, so more maintenance will be required. Feedback leads to oscillatory response. As we are adding some feedback elements, so system stability become issue, and so the more oscillation in the output response. So overall gain is reduced due to presence of the feedback. By earlier example we see system have itself or own gain, and if we add a feedback element over there, it have its own gain. And similarly, controller have its own gain, so it will add more gain into the system, so that will reduce the overall gain of the system. Stability is a major problem, and more care is needed to design a stable closed loop system. So this is the main disadvantage of this, because in every control system, stability is main concern. So during the design, it will take in consideration like that, stability should be maintained. So this is all about the control system in like open loop and closed loop system comparison. Thank you very much. Stay tuned with us for more videos on control system. Please like and subscribe our channel. Thank you.